We are going to discuss now the model calculation for the reciprocating pump. So there are some observations for reciprocating pump. Length of the collecting tank is 30 cm, breadth of the collecting tank is 30 cm, and height of collecting tank, it depends. Okay, now we have taken in the experiments, we have taken for 3 cm, it can be varied also. Now let me assume it as 3 cm. And the static suction head for the reciprocating pump is 36 cm. And this one, the specific weight of water, it is known to us 9810 Newton per meter cube. So these are the observations for the reciprocating pump. And similar to the previous pumps, efficiency of the motor, it is 0.85. Efficiency of the energy meter is 0.85. Energy meter constant is 720 revolution per kilowatt hour. So these are the observations you should know before we go for the reciprocating pump experiments. Now let me give one reading and we will explain the model calculation for that reading. Now PS is 150 and pressure gauge reading, it is 1.2, and time taken is 13.23, and time taken for revolution, it is 36.1. Now we are going to do the calculation for this particular experiment. Again here it is given in terms of centimeter, it is not going to be in centimeter, it is going to be in terms of millimeter. So it is 150 mm of Hg. So like this we will be taking a set of readings for five set of readings. Now we are going to proceed with the formula. Efficiency is equal to output by input. Output of the pump is WW, because reciprocating pump will pump the water, so we are going to write specific weight of the water, into Q into capital H. Specific weight of water, it is known to us, we have wrote in the observation, so 9810 Newton per meter cube. So WW is over. Now to calculate Q, we have volume, which is length into breadth into height. So this H and this H is different. This is the height of the tank. This capital H is the total head or total pressure head. It applies for all the pumps divided by time taken. So volume is 0.3 into 0.3, length is 30 cm, breadth is 30 cm, and height we have assumed it as 3 cm, so it is 0.03 divided by time. Time is this time. Time taken for H cm, H we have assumed here as 3 cm. So 13.23. So Q is equal to answer in terms of meter cube per second. So we have got this column, Q. Now to calculate H, we have HS plus HD plus we have another term called HG. So actually in this formula, there is a term called static suction head, it is HG. So it is the difference between two pressure gauges. So it is going to be constant. So how to calculate HS? If you look at the formula, vacuum gauge reading in mm of Hg into specific gravity of the mercury. So this will be the reading. So vacuum gauge reading in terms of it is in meter of Hg, because we are going to take all the reading terms of meter, but we have noted down in mm of Hg. So 150, this is mm. So to convert this mm into meter, we divide it by 1000. So this 1000 is to convert millimeter into meter. Into specific gravity of Mercury is 13.6. So HS equal to meter of water. So we have calculated HS. Now to calculate HD, pressure gauge reading in kg per centimeter square into G into 10 power 4 divided by specific weight of water. So which is equal to 1.2 here. So 1.2 into G is 9.81 into 10 power 4. Specific weight of water is 9810. So I'll write it as 9.81 into 1000. So to cancel it, so 1.2 into 10. So this is my HD. So 12 meter of water. So HD we have got. For calculating total head, we have got HS, we have got HD. HG is given as, this is given as 36 centimeters, so 0.36 meter observation. It is given the observation, so we can add HS plus HD plus HG to get total head. So we have got total head here, this column is filled. So once we know WW, Q and H, we can calculate output power. So output power column is also over. So whichever we have calculated, so let us name this as PS, let us name this as HS, this as PD, and this as HD. Here this is, we have calculated this column, we have calculated this column, and we have calculated this column also. So this completely filled, only left is input power. Now to calculate input power, to calculate input power, 3600 into 1000 into n into eta 1 into eta 2 divided by c into t 1. So 3600 into 1000 into number of revolutions. Number of revolutions for reciprocating pump, it is going to be 5. 5 into 0.85 divided by C is 720 into T1 is 36.1, we will get input power. Efficiency equal to output by input, we will get in terms of percentage efficiency. So this N, regarding this N, whatever value we take for that, if you take n equal to 5, this time will vary. If you take n equal to 10, that time will increase. So correspondingly, whatever value we have got, so while we are going for the real calculation, we will be sharing this table with the readings. By the time we will be giving the exact value of n to that, correspondingly this time will vary. This is applicable for all the pumps. So that is the end of reciprocating pump calculation.